Hi, and welcome to this channel. In this video, we will talk about right bundle branch block, or in short, RBBB. Its ECG features, causes, and differential diagnosis. Right bundle branch block is said to be present when QRS duration is greater than 120 milliseconds. In leads V1 to V3, there is RSR pattern, or in other words, M-shaped QRS complex. In lateral leads including lead 1, AVL, V5, V6, S-wave is wide and slurred. And other associated features of right bundle branch block is that there is appropriate discordance, with ST depression with, or without T-wave inversion in right precordial leads, that is, V1 to V3. Few words about electrophysiology in right bundle branch block. Like explained earlier in our video on left bundle branch block, during normal cardiac conduction, impulses travel equally down the left and right bundles, and the septum is activated from left to right with the formation of small Q waves in lateral leads. In right branch block, the left ventricle is activated normally, thus the early part of the QRS complex correlating to septal depolarization is unchanged. There is delayed activation of the right ventricle, because the depolarization here now originates from the left ventricle across the septum. This produces a secondary R wave, denoted as a prime, in the precordial leads. And in lateral leads, there are wide and slurred S waves. Normal activation of the left ventricle means that cardiac axis remains normal in isolated right bundle branch block. Let's now see ECG QRS morphology in right bundle branch block. In lead V1 to V3, there is RSR pattern. Sometimes rather than an RSR pattern in V1, there may be a broad monophasic R wave, or a QR complex, denoted a small Q and capital R wave representing small Q wave and taller wave. In lateral leads, there is wide slurred S wave. There is appropriate discordance, which refers to the fact that abnormal depolarization should be followed by abnormal repolarization. And this repolarization, or ST segment, appears discordant to the preceding QRS complex. In right bundle branch block, this manifests as ST depression, with or without T-wave inversion in leads V1 to V3. Coming on to the causes of right bundle branch block. The right bundle branch is supplied by left anterior descending artery perforators in most patients, and thus occlusion of this branch may manifest as a new right bundle branch block with or without left anterior fascicular block. There is increasing literature suggesting that in the context of chest pain, a new right bundle branch block is highly concerning for acute myocardial infarction, and a potential indication for immediate reperfusion therapy. If there is concordance instead of discordance in anterior leads in patient with chest pain and right bundle branch block, it is suggestive of acute myocardial infarction. Conditions leading to right bundle branch block include right ventricular hypertrophy, cor pulmonale, pulmonary embolism, ischemic heart disease, rheumatic heart disease, congenital heart disease, for example atrial septal defect, myocarditis, cardiomyopathy, Lini-Gruev disease, which is a primary degenerative disease of the conducting system. Differential diagnosis of right bundle branch block include the Brugada syndrome, where also RSR pattern is seen in V1 to V3. This condition needs to be picked because it is associated with malignant ventricular arrhythmias. And that is it for this video. Thank you for watching. Please like this video, share with your colleagues, and subscribe to this channel.